Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to continue the sound design series here at BusyWorksBeats.com/sound design. Today we're going to go over how filters can actually override your amp envelopes. What I mean by this is that a lot of people like to shape their sound using what's called an ADSR, an attack, decay, sustain, release envelope, which is your general envelope used for amplitude. But this only controls the volume. What we can do is actually override this with a filter envelope. So what I'm saying is we can make sounds feel shorter, you know, based on our filter. So for example, let's prove this by giving a sound a very short decay. So it's pretty long. I want to make it long enough to where we understand that we're making it shorter with the filter. So let me make it a little bit longer. So that's our amp envelope. Now what I'm going to do is set up a low pass filter. This is great for low pass filters because it takes out most of the frequency. So this technique is usually used by low pass filters, and this is great for electronic genres. So what we can do is set our low pass filter. Now here's the tone. What I want to do is set up a new envelope. So let's go to envelope 2 and let's turn down the sustain so we have only decay. Now notice how the second envelope is shorter than the first envelope. You see the first envelope in the background is grayed out. This envelope now is shorter than the original envelope in decay. Let's drag that envelope over to our cutoff. We need to tell the filter where to stop. So I'm going to left click to drag our range here. So it's going to start open at this position and it's going to close on the left position. I'm going to turn up resonance so we can hear what's going on. So the filter is moving down using this decay curvature. So for example, if I left the decay longer than the amplitude would die out before the filter died out in decay. But what if I shorten the decay to where it's faster than the amplitude? It makes the sound feel like it's shorter in amplitude. So this is one of those kind of hacks, I guess you could say, to make your sound feel more plucky, as they say. This is how you get the pluck sound other than just using an amp envelope to create a pluck tone. So let me set up some chords so we can kind of demo what I'm talking about here, and it'll be clear once we write out some chords. So let's write out, I guess, what, G major? And what's another cool chord? Let's do a couple inversions. Let's do G major and then swap out the root note for E. And that's not a dance tempo, is it? Let's do 108. So now I'm just trying to configure a rhythm. Okay, I'm too much of a perfectionist when it comes to demo tunes, but here's what we're going to work with. So let's say I want to make this shorter. So if I didn't have the envelope on or the filter on, it would just sound like this based on the decay curvature of the amplitude. Give it a little release for the reverb effect. But let's say you want to make it more pluck sounding. That's where the second envelope is going to come into play. So let's activate our filter, low pass filter, and give it an envelope. And that's how we create that pluck type of sound. It overrides the amplitude. But what happens if I open up the filter? We start to hear that tail. That's because most of the frequencies are high frequency information. So when we add the low pass filter, it feels like we're turning off the amplitude, but really we're just masking those higher frequencies. So you can move this cutoff knob around if you want to create more of a tail over time. So let's set LFO 1 to go slowly up over time, and let's set it to BPM. Let's set it to 16 bars, and let's control the cutoff knob in a linear fashion. So it's going to start low, go high. Oh, you know what? It's restarting the sound. So let's turn off the trigger mode. I forget where it's Do envelope. I forget how to actually turn this thing off to where it resets. Whatever. Let me make this a long. I think I just set it up to not work. Anyway, let me do automation instead of an LFO, because I think I confused the system to reset the LFO. That's not what I want. So I need to remove the modulator from LFO 1, and it still controls it with the envelope. So let's open that back up. So all I'm going to do here is just modulate this manually. So I'm going to move it, go to plug-in options, go to browse parameters. We're going to find the filter cutoff. We're going to right-click, create automation clip. Over time, I want it to go up in value. So I'm going to right-click, copy the first value, and let it build over 8 bars. And now we can add our music in. So now you're going to hear more and more of that tail open up, because we're letting go of the low frequencies. We're letting go of the low pass filter slowly over time. So it's allowing more and more of those high frequencies to come through, which allows the perception of this to fade away. So this is a more advanced way to think about filter envelopes. Thickening up the sound so you can get a better idea of what it would sound like if I were to actually. Let's make it build over a longer period, and then I'm going to wrap up the video. So again, let's break this down into layers. The first layer is that we're looking at envelope shapes. Remember, this works with the low pass filter. So to get the more of a pluck sound, you can actually override your amplitude envelope, which is envelope 1. You can override that with a shorter envelope in envelope 2, which controls your what's called the cutoff frequency for your low pass filter. So the low pass, what it's doing is masking those high frequencies. So it's going from an open filter to a closed filter. So it's masking all the high frequency information over that amount of time. And it's so quick that it masks all those high frequencies, and it makes it feel as if the sound became shorter. But in reality, it didn't become shorter. We're just masking those high frequencies. But like I said, the more advanced way to think about it is, okay, now that we've understand that section, what if we automate or modulate this cutoff filter point, filter frequency point, to move up over time? We're going to allow more and more high frequencies to be perceived. So this envelope becomes less and less apparent over time based on our cutoff filter frequency point. So that's a more advanced way to think about this. I added white noise just to add texture to the sound. That automation, by simply moving the cutoff filter, we made it seem like we're opening up the release tail of that amp envelope. But in reality, all we're doing is just slowly getting rid of this mask used in envelope 2. So that is a more advanced way to think about it. There's plenty of ways to do the same thing doing different techniques. But that's how you get that specific sound. So if you want to learn more about sound design, go to busyworksbeats.com/sound design. We have a free course going over the fundamentals of sound design. So if you were confused about a term or some type of thing I was talking about, I explain it in that free course. Okay, so click that link below and you can sign up for free today. It's busyworksbeats.com. www.lowpassfilter.com.